Before we get started, let me remind you, Bar Nancy is selling to-go drinks. Call them up or follow them. They'll hook you up. They have all their information on Facebook and Instagram. The Ben's Flipside Bottle Shop is open. You can go see Hector there. Go fuck Hector and tell him to sell you something. He's got all the craft beers. He's got the growlers, all that stuff over there at the Ben. Or, I mean, at the Flipside. But remember, before you, when you come in and when you leave, say it like everybody else, fuck Hector. That'll get you the Trivia Miami discount of 0% off. And Sandbar, I'm sure, is still doing food deliveries. Check with them. Go on their Facebook. Call them. I'm not sure what they got, if they got any specials, but call them up. I'm sure they got deliveries in the General Grove area or however they're doing it. Has Danny got it on here yet? Danny's always late. There he is. Now that Danny's arrived, we can get started. Friday. It's after 7 o'clock. Time now for home trivia. If you don't already have a bucket that you found in your backyard or somewhere in your house, go get your buckets now, or at least, at the very least, get a piece of paper and a pen so you can write down your answers. Right now, let's get started by going over the rules of tonight's game.
It's Friday, you bastard.
As always, we have a one-player minimum, but please stay 6 feet apart from each other. You need at least one person to play. You can have as many people as you want. Obviously, you shouldn't have anybody in your house. Everybody should be at least 6 feet apart from each other, and you should have no guests in your house. But I'm sure if you can do one of those watch parties, you can do that as many as you want. I have no way of checking your papers or your answers anyway, so you figure it out on your own. Please come up with a funny team name and write it in the comments. If I catch it while I'm reading them here, I have a separate tablet watching the same feed you're watching so I can see what your comments are as they go. I'll try to see if I catch one. I'll say it on the microphone. Scream and shout the answers all you want. I can't hear you. Only your neighbors can hear you. So it's your problem, your noise ordinances. All right, here's the one we have to, an honor system between us all. Don't look up the answers. And if you know the answer, don't post it in the comments. Remember, you're playing with yourself, so you would only be cheating yourself. But let everybody have a fair chance. There's no prizes to win. There's no point of cheating. We're all doing this for fun and to, you know, have some sense of normality in this period. So don't look up the answers and don't post the answers. Questions round one are worth 1 point each. Question round two are worth 2 points each. Question round three are worth 5 points each. And you pretty much give yourselves prizes if you feel you won. You can give yourself a first place, give yourself a second place. And if possible, as you're playing, as you got your friends on the screens, as you got it going, take pictures of yourselves and tag me in them at Trivia Miami, and I'll see if I can repost them or send it to me through the private messages on this page or on the Instagram or however. Also, time. Also, at one point, we will be pulling out our stubs and dancing in the Lucky SOB raffle, where I pull out numbers from a bucket, my son wins the prizes, and that's pretty much it. The Lucky SOB raffle. This time it stands for Son of a Bernie. Here's some of the pictures I got last time. That's a Patrick playing. He took a picture. He sent it to me, so I'm posting it here for you guys to see. Remember, Patrick is the star singer and songwriter for the group that made this album, where Patrick fondles sheep. This is another one they sent me. Those are the cunts. And here's our legal disclaimer. If you can read small and fast, if you even bother trying to read it, I didn't change any of the information on there. And it makes no sense for us now, and it makes no sense for us later. Also, as I always say, before the Corona boys, there was the Zika boys, and Broses still sucks. We will say that every week, since Broses does not go to trivia anymore, and he has not yet been online. He is somewhere hiding in a bunker, taking care of his Hitler memorabilia. So let's get started with tonight's game. It's time now. Grab your phones and look at them if you're using that to watch us, or put them in the buckets or whatever. You know what to do. We're going to get started with round one. Get a piece of paper, write down 1 through 10. You're going to write these down and score them yourselves. We just started. You can still join, whoever just put that comment there. Remember, don't post the answers in the comments. Keep the answers written down to yourselves. Score your own sheets. So let's get started. Round one. Question one. True or false? There was once a Brooklyn Dodgers NFL team. True or false? I realized I didn't have my stopwatch. Jedi Adventures just joined. All right, question two. In which country do people speak the language they call Nihongo? In which country do people speak the language they call Nihongo? I may not be reading that right, but it sounds better that way. Question three. In 1995, which color of M&M was voted into packages by the public? A, blue, B, purple, or C, red? Okay, 1995, which color of M&M was voted into packages by the public? Blue, purple, or red? Yes, Patrick, we're aware that the album cover that I photoshopped is a NoFX album. It's still funny. We got Team Quarantine Queens. Mr. Jay Exotic is also here. All right, question four. Who does Eddie Murphy trade places with in the 1983 movie Trading Places? Who does Eddie Murphy trade places with in the 1983 movie, Trading Places? All right, question five. What pop star is the founder of the Lamb fashion line? What pop star is the founder of the Lamb fashion line? Question six. What was the real name of the whale who starred in the movie Free Willy? A. Keiko, B. Piero, or C. Sorba? And what was the real name of the whale who starred in the movie Free Willy? A. Keiko, B. Piero, or C. Sorba? Question seven. Which South Park character famously received an anal probe in their first episode? Which South Park character famously received an anal probe in their first episode? Question 8. The piranha fish is native to which continent? The piranha fish is native to which continent? Question 9. Which country was alarmed by an outbreak of mad cow disease in 1996? A. France, B. Germany, or C. United Kingdom? And which country was alarmed by an outbreak of mad cow disease in 1996? A. France, B. Germany, or C. the United Kingdom? Had somebody actually text me trying to figure out how to get on here, and I'm like, just go to Facebook. We should be there, right? I found it. I don't recognize the number, but hopefully they'll get on. Whoever it was, hopefully you're already on here. Finally, question 10, everybody's favorite category. Florida. I'm going to read a news headline. You need to let me know if you think it's Florida or not Florida. The only two possible answers are Florida or not Florida. Not true or false, not yes or no. Either way, I can't check your answer, but you either have to write Florida or not Florida, nothing else. Here is the headline. Two men walking to CVS say they have the virus, steal two cases of Corona beer. Is that Florida or not Florida? That's the end of round one. Let's go over the questions one more time in case you missed any. Question one was true or false. There was once a Brooklyn Dodgers NFL team. Question two, in which country do people speak the language they call Nihongo? Question three, in 1995, which color of M&M was voted into packages by the public? A, blue, B, purple, or C, red? Question four, who does Eddie Murphy trade places with in the 1983 movie Trading Places? Question 5, what pop star is the founder of the Lamb fashion line? Question 6, what was the real name of the whale who starred in the movie Free Willy? A, Keiko, B, Piero, or C, Sorba? Question 7, which South Park character famously received an anal probe in their first episode? Question 8, the piranha fish is native to which continent? Question 9, which country was alarmed by an outbreak of mad cow disease in 1996? A, France, B, Germany, or C, the United Kingdom? And Florida or not Florida, the headline read, two men walking to CVS say they have the virus, steal two cases of Corona beer. Is that Florida or not Florida? All right, please check your own answer sheets. Figure out your own scores. Right now, let me get everything ready for the raffle. Let me get my participants in the background here. Camera on. Music down. Let me get my... My assistant, my daughter Leticia, is there ready to hand out prizes, and hopefully my son will be there to win these prizes. I got the bucket already here, so let's get started. All right, it's time to pull out your stubs. It's raffle time. I'm going to pull a number out of this bucket, and if his number matches my number, my son will win. He will win all nine prizes. So right now, let me go at the first number, winning the first prize. Remember, if my number matches any number, my son will win. Here we go. Five, seven, one. Did you win?
Yeah.
Dance. All right, he won. You didn't stay with me. You lucky son of a Bernie. All right, next one out, we'll be getting another prize going out to the following number. I'm actually getting tickets out of a bucket. I'm not just making this up. 566-566. That you?
Yeah.
Dance. All right, he won. You didn't stay with me. You lucky son of a Bernie. And finally, everybody's favorite prize, one free beer. Now, since he is 12 years old and he is not 21 years old, I will be getting the free beer. He instead will get whatever prize my daughter gives him. Going out to the following number. Five, seven, seven. You won? Dance.
B stands for Broncos, BMW, Bass, Bengals, and a pair of balls. We see us pulling up down the avenue, act like we are stars. We're not trying.
All right, he won. You didn't stay with me. Lucky son of a Bernie. And that concludes the lucky son of a Bernie raffle for this round. If you still have your tickets, hold on to them, Bernardo. We have more prizes for you after round two and three of tonight's game. Right now, let's go over the answers from round one. Question one was, true or false, there was once a Brooklyn Dodgers NFL team? That was true, back in 1940, I guess. Two, in which country do people speak the language they call Nihongo? Japan, Abong. In 1995, which color of M&M was voted into packages by the public? Blue. Question four, who does Eddie Murphy trade places with in the 1983 movie Trading Places? Dan Aykroyd. Question five, what pop star is the founder of the Lamb fashion line? Gwen Stefani. Hold on. Okay. Question six, what was the real name of the whale who starred in the movie Free Willy? Keiko. Question seven, which South Park character famously received an anal probe in their first episode? Cartman. That's Bernie Roses, who is the grown-up version of Cartman, who also does not participate in trivia anymore, which is why Bernie Roses, Broses, sucks. Question 8, the piranha fish is native to which continent? South America. And which country was alarmed by an outbreak of mad cow disease in 1996? United Kingdom. Florida or not Florida, the headline read, two men walking to CVS, they say they have the virus, steal two cases of Corona beer. That was Florida. Those are the two guys right there. All right, add up your scores. They're 1 point each this round. Post your scores in the comments, and I will take a couple minutes here break with a commercial from the past.
Lazy days, warm and free, pathways to climb, rivers to see. Magic's here for you and me as we travel the roads to romance.
A visit to Coral Gables, one of the world's most beautiful cities, may well feature a trip to the new campus of the University of Miami.
Miami.
Today, thronged by students from both Americas, the campus is an outstanding example of modern architecture. Freshwater swimming in the world-famous Venetian pools, fed by cool artesian wells, is open to all visitors in the area. From the mainland, a causeway stretches across sparkling Biscayne Bay to Cape Florida and to Crandon Beach, certainly one of the most magnificent bathing beaches in the world. This park area, operated as a county playground, is shaded by thousands of graceful palms and was once part of America's largest coconut plantation. Fine roads and highways bring many sightseeing points of interest in the surrounding area within easy reach of the vacationist. Here is a case of giving the visitor the bird. A gaudy, colorful, and noisy costume. These macaws are completely free to fly about, with no cages, nets, or fences to restrain them. You and your family can enjoy the vacation thrills of this spot, and no matter where you live, you can reach it quickly, comfortably, and with utmost economy. Travel this year the roads to romance, to places you have always wanted to go. And when you travel, go in one of the quality motor cars your Chevrolet dealer has to offer. It will be your magic carpet that will carry you to the land of your heart's desire.
All right, I see you all posted your scores. I'm not going to read them. That's going to take too long. But it's time again to put your phones in the buckets or wherever the hell, unless you're using it to watch us. We're going to start round two of tonight's game. Phones in the buckets, phones in the buckets. Alan, shut the fuck up. I don't know if he's here or not, but I imagine he's talking too much wherever he is. So let's get started with round two. Question one. What came out first, Dreamgirls or Norbit? Both with Eddie Murphy. What came out first? Question two. Which Marlins player was the 1997 World Series MVP? Which Marlins player was the 1997 World Series MVP? Which Peanuts character did Black Eyed Peas singer Fergie once voice in the mid-1980s? Which Peanuts character did Black Eyed Peas singer Fergie once voice in the mid-80s? For some reason, Patrick's talking about his bunghole. I guess his team is Warner Bros. Again. Question four is always our anal bum cover. I'm sorry, an album cover. Who's? Oh, not this one. This is the wrong album cover. This is DJ TJ's album that recorded live acoustic music at the Bend once. That's not the album cover we're working on. This one. Whose 1990 album is that the cover for? Just the name of the artist, not the name of the album. Whose 1990 album is that the cover for? Question five. Andre Benjamin and Antoine Patton are the duo better known as what rap group? Andre Benjamin and Antoine Patton are the duo better known as what rap group?
Time since my
All right, it's time now for question six, which is our movie clips. I'm going to play a clip from a movie. It was released in 1979. If you know what it is, write it down. I'll play it once with just the sound and once with the words up on the screen. Listen closely.
Crucifixion lasts hours. It's a slow, horrible death.
Well, at least it gets you out in the open air.
One more time.
Crucifixion lasts hours. It's a slow, horrible death.
Well, at least it gets you out in the open air.
What movie is that from? Yeah, by the way, this round, they're all 2 points each. 2 points each. I will put that at the end, but in case you're trying to keep track question by question. Question seven. Who are the only two U.S. presidents that signed the Declaration of Independence? Who are the only two U.S. presidents that signed the Declaration of Independence? Question 8. In which country was the board game Trivial Pursuit invented? In which country was the board game Trivial Pursuit invented? Question 9. Who was the shortest player ever to play in the NBA? Who was the shortest player ever to play in the NBA? Finally, question 10, last question this round. Which author wrote the novel, The Da Vinci Code? Which author wrote the novel, The Da Vinci Code? That's the end of round two. Let's go over the questions one more time in case you missed any. Question one was, what came out first, Dreamgirls or Norbit? Both with Eddie Murphy. Question two, which Marlins player was the 1997 World Series MVP? Three, which Peanuts character did Black Eyed Peas singer Fergie once voice in the mid-1980s? Anal Bump Cover. Not this one. That's DJ TJ's album. Don't buy that. Whose 1990 album is this, the cover for? Just the name of the artist, not the name of the album. Question 5. Andre Benjamin and Antoine Patton are the duo better known as what rap group? Movie clip released in 1979.
Crucifixion lasts hours. It's a slow, horrible death.
Well, at least it gets you out in the open air.
What movie is that from? Question 7. Who were the only two U.S. presidents that signed the Declaration of Independence? In which country was the board game Trivial Pursuit invented? Question 9. Who was the shortest player ever to play in the NBA? Question 10. Which author wrote the novel The Da Vinci Code? All right, please check your own answer sheets. See if you got your scores put together. Let me get my kids up here so we can get going with the raffle. You can look it up now. Do whatever you got to do ahead of time. Either way, I'll be revealing the answers after the raffle. Let me get the bucket ready. Here we go. All right, it's time to pull out your stubs. It's raffle time. I'm going to put a number out of this bucket. And any number I pull out of here, my son will win the prize. Again, my daughter's got the prizes. She's standing right over there. And yes, all three of us are wearing Nirvana shirts. I'm going to pull out the first number. Getting a prize will be 574, 574. You won?
Yeah.
Dance. All right, he won. You didn't say with me. You lucky son of a Bernie. All right, next one out. Getting another prize for my daughter. 573, 573. You again? Dance.
Lucia.
Oh, yeah.
All right, he won. You didn't say it with me. You lucky son of a Bernie. Let's wait for the good part. Sucia guy playing at Bar Nancy. Highlight of my entire trivia career. And finally, everybody's favorite prize, one free beer. One free beer, which I will get at the end of the game. Because my son is 12, he's not 21, so I will drink it in his behalf. Here we go. 567, 567. You again? Dance. All right. He won. You didn't say it with me. You lucky son of a Bernie. And that concludes our lucky son of a Bernie raffle for this round. Bernardo still has his tickets. Hold on to them because we have more prizes coming up after round three. All right, let's go over the answers from round two. Question one was, what came out first, Dreamgirls or Norbit? Both of Eddie Murphy. Dreamgirls. Question 2. Which Marlins player was the 1997 World Series MVP? Livan Hernandez. I love Miami. Question 3. Which Phoenix character did Black Eyed Peas singer Fergie once voice in the mid-1980s? Sally. That girl. The Anal Bump Cover. Not that one. That's DJ TJ. This one, whose 1990 album is this the cover for? Jane's Addiction. Okay, Andre Benjamin and Antoine Patton are the duo better known as what rap group? Outkast. Movie clip released in 1979.
Crucifixion lasts hours. It's a slow, horrible death.
Well, at least it gets you out in the open air.
Life of Brian. So who were the only two U.S. presidents that signed the Declaration of Independence? Thomas Jefferson and John Adams. In which country was the board game Trivial Pursuit invented? Canada. And who's the shortest player ever to play in the NBA? Muggsy Bogues. And which author wrote the novel The Da Vinci Code? Dan Brown. All right, as I mentioned before, questions now are worth 2 points each. Add them up, see what you got right. Post them in the comments. Post your score in the comments. Now let's go to another classic commercial from South Florida's past.
If you're hungry and in the mood for something extraordinary, look for this symbol. And this telephone is the fastest way to Franco's original Italian pizza day or night. If you live anywhere from Pompano to Hialeah, you can treat yourself to the best in authentic Italian dishes. Franco's specializes in dishes from antipasto to veal francese, all at reasonable prices. This symbol of excellence is in Pompano, Fort Lauderdale, North Miami Beach, North Miami, and Hialeah. Franco's, the king of pizza with home delivery day or night.
97 GTR, continuous rock and roll with Herman and McBean Mornings.
No more pop scratches and ugly black buildups for these rock and roll animals. Whoa, whoa,
whoa, whoa. 97 GTR, all compact disc rock and roll.
Like ZZ Top. Bruce Springsteen. Baby, the Rolling Stones. Herman and McBean Mornings on 97 GTR, continuous rock and roll.
It's hard for many people to imagine that a Waterbed City waterbed is actually the ultimate surface to sleep on for improved health and comfort. Why, your life, you've been told, hard is better, and we understand that at Waterbed City. That's precisely why every Waterbed City waterbed is backed by our 30-night promise of satisfaction. If your waterbed doesn't dramatically improve your health and comfort, we'll refund your money. You have everything to gain and nothing to lose, and that's the way it should be, and is, at Waterbed City.
You could fill the Orange Bowl 5,000 times a year with all the tourists who come to Florida, and they pay over $700 million of your tax bill. But what if they didn't come? How big would your tax bill be then? Make it good for tourists, Florida. They make it very good for you.
Let's get started with round three. It's time again. Put your phones in the buckets if you're not using your phone to watch this game. Don't look up the answers, in other words. Round three. Get your papers. Write down these answers. All right. Question one. Jimmy Kimmel Live's announcer, Dickie Barrett, is also the lead singer of what band? Jimmy Kimmel Live's announcer, Dickie Barrett, is also the lead singer of what band? Question two. What animal has the largest mouth of all land animals? What animal has the largest mouth of all land animals? Hey, 20 bucks is 20 bucks, Patrick. Question three. Since it's time now to name a celebrity, I'm going to put a picture of a celebrity up there. If you know who it is, write down their real name, not a character name, not a description where you've seen them. Name this celebrity. I need his real name, not a character name, not a description where you've seen him.
This place is for the ride away. Just chasing after chasing. But do you believe Brian Tamaki is a dangerous man?
All right, let's just say question four, but it's question four. Not five, it's four. What heavy metal band was named after a Bob Dylan song? What heavy metal band was named after a Bob Dylan song? Again, this is question four, not five. I forgot to change the number up there. Now it's time for question five. This one is five, which is always our Jumble. 7 on top, 5 on the bottom. That is our LOS, CREWRULES. Hint, it's an actor, male. Figure it out. Best bet is to write this information down so you can keep working on it after we move on to the next question. Which we are doing now. It's timer to stop. Stop. Reset. All right. Question six. According to Greek mythology, who is the first woman on Earth? Question seven. Carbonade flamande, or however the fuck you say that, carbonade flamande is a dish made with what beverage? Carbonade flamande is a dish made with what beverage? Tam Wilson used to always tell me I should like read these ahead of time and practice them and get the enunciation right. I listened to him a few times, but some words I just can't figure out. But you can read it up there, right? Figure it on your own. All right, question eight. Something for Josh Silverman, which means it's a science question. What is the heaviest element with a one-letter symbol?
Fucking Tamaki.
You know, Josh, if you record yourself screaming Groove Boys Rule and send me the MP3 of that, I'll throw it in here somehow. Just something for you to think about. All right, question 9, Danny's favorite question. Who played Aragorn in The Lord of the Rings? Who played Aragorn in the Lord of the Rings? It's funny to watch the reactions as I read the questions when Danny comes on. It's helped me get through these 3 weeks of not working. And finally, question 10. Last question of tonight's game. Something of local history, news, or facts. What locally based national politician is the brother-in-law of a criminal that dealt drugs with Mario Tabrau from Netflix's Tiger King? Who's that? That's the end of round three. Let's go over the questions one more time in case you missed any. Question one was, Jimmy Kimmel Live's announcer Dickie Barrett is also the lead singer of what band? Question two, what animal has the largest mouth of all land animals? To name this celebrity, I need his real name, not a character name, not a description where you've seen him. Question five, what heavy metal band was named after a Bob Dylan song? And again, this is question four, not five. I forgot to change the number on the top. Question four, not five. Question five is actually the word jumble, which is seven on top, five on the bottom. Those are the letters. It's an actor, male. Los Crew Rules. Question six, according to Greek mythology, who was the first woman on Earth? Question seven, carbonade flamande or whatever is a dish made with what beverage? And something for Josh Silverman, what is the heaviest element with a one-letter symbol? Question nine, Danny's favorite question, who played Aragorn in The Lord of the Rings? And question 10, what locally based national politician is the brother-in-law of a criminal that dealt drugs with Mario Tabrau from Netflix's Tiger King? All right, please check your own answer sheets while I get the raffle put together. And remember, before we go on to the raffle, Bar Nancy is selling liquor bottles to go. You call them up, check with them on Facebook. They have all their phone numbers are on Instagram. All that. You can contact Liz or Katie or Ben or Sasha. They'll hook you up. The Ben's flip side is open, selling to go, craft beers, growlers, crawlers, all that good stuff. And Sandbar also has food for delivery and for takeout. So contact them as well. Now let's go on to the raffle. They're asleep playing on their phones. All right, it's time to pull out your stubs. It's raffle time. I'll pull a number out of this bucket, and if your number matches my number, my son wins. Getting the first number, my daughter will give him the first prize. Let's see what number we get. 569. You won?
Yes.
Dance. All right, he won. You didn't. Stay with me. You lucky son of a Bernie.
Le gusta el pastel a tu gente, el melonero. Le gusta la carne a
see what number we get next. And again, my son will win the next prize too. Oh, the one that flew up. Not that it makes a difference. 564, 564. Dance.
Moviendo la cadera, moviendo la cadera, moviendo la cadera, moviendo la cadera, moviendo la cadera.
All right, he won. You didn't say with me. You lucky son of a Bernie. And finally, everybody's favorite prize, one free beer, which I will get because my son is 12 years old, not 21. He can't have it, so I'll have it on his behalf. Let's see what number we get. 572, 572. You win again?
Yeah.
Dance.
Opa, like a high at the edge, place to go. It's more than just a market, it's a great big show.
All right, he won. You didn't say with me. You lucky son of a Bernie. And that concludes our lucky son of a Bernie raffle for tonight's game. All right, let's go over the answers from round three. Which one was Jimmy Kimmel Live's announcer, Dickie Barrett, is also the lead singer of what band? The Mighty Mighty Bosstones. And two, what animal has the largest mouth of all land animals? The hippopotamus. However, I would have also have accepted the Alanonymous. Alan has a bigger mouth than most hippos as well, because he talks so much shit. To name this celebrity, that is Adam Scott. Question four, what heavy metal band was named after a Bob Dylan song? Judas Priest. Word jumble, seven on top, five on the bottom, those are the letters. It is Russell Crowe. Question six, according to Greek mythology, who was the first woman on Earth? Pandora. Question seven, carbonate flamande is a dish made with what beverage? Beer. All right, something for Josh. What is the heaviest element with a one-letter symbol? Uranium. Question 9, Danny's favorite question. Who played Aragorn in The Lord of the Rings? Viggo Mortensen. And question 10, what locally based national politician is the brother-in-law of a criminal that dealt drugs with Mario Tebow from Netflix's Tiger King? Little Marquito Rubio. You know what they say about Little Marquito Rubio?
Marica tú,
marica yo,
marica jaja,
marica quién,
marica tú,
marica yo,
marica jaja,
marica quién,
marica tú,
marica yo.
I'm glad he's back in the news so I can make fun of him. Again, those questions are all 5 points each. Add up your scores, figure it out, post them in the comments. Let's go to some classic South Florida commercials. And post your score in the comments so you all can see how you all did. Be honest. Again, it makes no difference. There are no prizes to be given out.
Grand Prix's new track. Grand Prix is bigger, longer, and faster. Feel the thrill of the hairpin turns. Then speed down the long straightaways. Grand Prix. Race your friends in the true spirit of Grand Prix competition racing. Feel the roar of the engines as you race the big challenge on Grand Prix Race-A-Rama. Open 7 days and nights. Take I-95 or Exit 12 on the turnpike. Grand Prix on 441 just south of State Road 84 in Fort Lauderdale.
Now, in Miami, one-day denture service for $50.
I'm Dr. Palin. We can custom fit you with dentures in 1 day. Visit us in the morning, and in most cases have your dentures that same afternoon.
I'm Dr. Richardson. Our other denture-related services include extractions, relines, repairs, and partial dentures.
Call 625-5400 in Miami. Drs. Palin and Richardson. One-day custom-fitted upper or lower dentures for $50. For information and appointment, call 625-5400.
Come aboard, we're expecting you.
All right, that's our classic commercials. Yes, I reached out to Elgin or B-Boy Cause, and he gave me permission to play that commercial. All right, I see you guys have posted your scores, but now before we move on, it is time now for another classic chug-off. Another one, more than likely. You know who's going to win and lose in this.
Where's Wayne Rogers? You wait until the other guy gets you. Put it down. Nice thing. Are you guys coming or not? Wayne Rogers Super Team. Chug off.
Wayne Rogers.
Chug off. You guys, get over here. Get over here. Alan?
What's going on?
That's a different team, Alan. Get over here. Alan, get Alan here. Come here. Here. Alright, when I say go, each one, grab your beers. When I say go, you need to chuck those beers as fast as you can while spilling first one, put the empty cup on the counter, went to go. You're gonna do that shit again, Alan. You suck, Alan. Alright, he wins. Wayne Rogers wins tonight's chug-off.
He did look like the guy, right? And that's tonight's chug-off. Remember, thoughts and prayers to Linda, who is spending all her days and nights stuck in the house with Alan. My advice is kick Alan in the nuts and help him, make him shut up. And like I said, I'll do this every Friday until we're allowed to go back in the bars. So join me again here next Friday. To me, you're all winners, regardless of what your scores were up here. You guys have your bragging rights up there yourselves. I'm not even going to. I'll look at it later. So to me, you're all winners for joining me. Spread the word. Get some more people in here. Let's make this a fun thing that we can do every Friday. Remember, you can follow me on Instagram, Facebook, and Twitter at Trivia Miami. Also, you can search Trivia Miami on YouTube. You can watch this whole game all over again. And I have the website, TriviaMiami.com. Once things get back to normal, you'll catch me over at Bar Nancy on Mondays. In the meanwhile, contact them if you for your bottles of mixed drinks and all that. They're selling all that stuff. On Wednesdays, you'll catch me at the Bend over in Miami Lakes. The flip side is open. They're selling beers. Hector's there. Remember, you can always tell Hector, fuck Hector. Friday at Sandbar, once this all goes back to normal, I think they're still selling food for takeout and delivery. And like
fuck
I always said,
Hector.
Exactly. Fuck Hector. And... Again, any little bit helps. I haven't worked in 3 weeks. But here's our end of the night video that I always played during karaoke for those of you who have been missing karaoke as well.
It's easy to grin when your ship comes in and you've got the stock market beat. But the man worthwhile is the man who can smile when his shorts aren't too tight in the seat.
So we finish 18, and he's gonna stiff me. And I say, hey, Lama, hey, how about a little something, you know, for the effort, you know? And he says, oh, there won't be any money. But when you die on your deathbed, you will receive total consciousness. So I got that going for me, which is nice.
Hey, buddy, I'm not paying you to hear your thoughts on life. I'm paying you to sing.
Well, I have a microphone, and you don't.
So you will listen to every damn word I have to say!
What? Over? Did you say over? Nothing is over until we decide it is! Was it over when the Germans bombed Pearl Harbor? Hell no!
Germans? Forget it, he's rolling.
And it ain't over now. Cause when the going gets tough, the tough get going. Who's with me? Let's go. Come on.
Fat, drunk, and stupid is no way to go through life, son.
I'ma call you. But if you come by, I won't call you. Okay? Don't ever come by here. Okay?
fuck you, fuck you, fuck you. You're cool. And fuck you, I'm out.
My advice to you
is to start drinking heavily.
So say goodnight to the bad guy.
Hey, everybody, we're all gonna get laid.
I don't give a fuck.
They took the bar. The whole fucking bar.
Fuck your couch, nigga. Fuck your couch.
Cocaine is a hell of a drug.
Hey, felt for him. Motherfucker, dick, pussy, snot, and shit. Good night. Good night. Suck my dick. Bye-bye.
Baboon, you know what they say? Some things in life are bad. They can really make you mad. Other things just make you swear and curse. When you're chewing on life's gristle, don't grumble, give a whistle. And this'll help things turn out for the best. And always look on the bright side of life. Always look on the light side of life. If life seems jolly rotten, there's something you've forgotten, and that's to laugh and smile and dance and sing. When you're feeling in the dumps, don't be silly chumps, just purse your lips and whistle, that's the thing. And always look on the bright side of life. Come on! Always look on the right side of life. For life is quite absurd, and death's the final word. You must always face the curtain with a bow. Forget about your scene, give the audience a grin. Enjoy it, it's your last chance anyhow.
So always look on the bright side of death. Just before you draw your terminal breath.
Life's a piece of shit when you look at it. Life's a laugh and death's a joke, it's true. You'll see it's all a show. Keep them laughing as you go. Just remember that the last laugh is on you. And
always look on the bright side. Always look on the right side of life.
Come on,
always look on the right side of life. Always look on the right side of life.
First things out to sea, you know.
Always look on the right side of life.
What you got to lose? You know, you come from nothing, you go back to nothing. What you lost? Nothing will come from nothing, you know what I say?
Oh,
cheer up, you old bugger.
Right,
give us a grin. There you are. See? The end of the film. Incidentally, this record's available in the foyer.
Always look on the right.
Someone's got to live as well, you know? Who do you think pays for this rubbish?